See, to start with, I have to confess that I was a very bad student in school. I failed twice in 10th standard, I failed twice in intermediate, and I failed twice in engineering. So I think it's very ironical that we are talking about RGB school. Though it's called unschooled, its intention is to be schooled. See, right from the beginning of my career, for some reason, I never said that it is the media which invented this world RGB school. And they kept on saying, this film looks like RGB school, or that director is from RGB school, or things like that, as RGB school, and I'm shot in this thing. I never ever really thought. I mean, filmmaking can be taught. No, because it is an expression of the person, how he wants to tell the story. So the idea for me here is, when I never ever had anything, and many other directors like that. So what they are thinking from inside, an expression which converts into the various forms of cinematic art, whether it is camera work or music or whatever it is, you know. And when I met Film Institute students from all over the place, and not any one particular institute, I felt that just following very old classical patterns of teaching, they expect them to understand very old time directors, like Battleship Potemkin. I'm not demeaning them, of course, they are great films for the time. But I don't think cinema today is about what it was intended when it started. There's a lot of comments involved, there's a lot of people's expectations, a lot of people's expectations for various reasons, you know. So I think today it's a professional school, of course. It's not more, no more a passion, just passion about an art. It's not that. So I think it's equally important to understand what made a blockbuster work. That doesn't mean one school is going to teach how to make a blockbuster. But I think it's important to analyze it. It's important to kind of dissect it and make the students understand what do they want to do. Do they want to become an Eisenstein, or do they want to become Rajmohli? Or do they want to learn from Citizen Kane? How do they want to learn from PK, for example? So I think unschooled is a very radical people. It will be exactly doing the opposite of what conventional film institutes will be doing. You know? And that precisely comes from my thought process of not me wanting to teach, or the unschooled, wants you to teach otherwise. When Shweta used this word, to make them unlearn. Like instinctively people have something, and then traditionally people try to make people understand something else. What you are thinking is wrong. You should think like this. You know, that is what schools do, that's what institutes do. But the unschool's point is to somehow make the students understand what their thinking is, right? And to only be able to tell them or guide them or steer them. Or to, steer them in a certain direction of what they themselves want to go, instead of trying to push them or making a way for them, is the simplest explanation I can give for the objectives of the unschool. And why it is called unschool is also for a reason, because when we are using the word to make people unlearn what it is about, then it obviously means it's unschooled on another way. You know? I'll share a small anecdote. When in Shiva, when I broke many rules, I didn't know even left and right of camera sometimes when I was directing my debut film. So even my technicians used to tell Nagarjuna and everyone that he doesn't even know left and right, how can he direct, and he doesn't know the basics or fundamentals of making, you know. And after the film world, they said there's new age. They said there's new age technique. You know? Now, why did I break the rules? Actually, I didn't break the rules. I didn't know the rules. So when I didn't know the rules, I just followed my heart and how I want to see it. You know? And that became whatever it became, you know. So similarly, I think any story or any given thing, different filmmakers are going to treat it differently, and their sensibilities will be different, and their way of wanting to capture will be different, their taste in music will be different. So the idea is to make them discover a filmmaker in themselves rather than trying to push a filmmaker into them. Any of the great filmmakers, when you're inspired or impressed or whatever one thinks, the bottom line is. So the thing is, one, you can be impressed, influenced, but you can also be impressed by a very unknown director, not necessarily what the institutes have determined as these are great directors. These are because they got awards. Or they got something. You can be inspired from a short film who nobody knows who made it. You know? So you're taking in things from whatever influenced you and impressed you, and you are trying to assimilate and absorb that. So Unschool will develop a process of doing it and systemize it, like what she said, you know, systemize and channelize a very radical and a very anarchic kind of thinking, you know, without having any rules and any kind of a disciplinary functions, for example, you know. So because of my reputation, if I am starting a school, you know, I am first of all a rowdy, you know, someone called me a celluloid terrorist. It's true, I don't know, it's true. But I hope and I intend through the Unschool to make, very, very individualistic. You know, when a lot of people say, only after RGV came, assistant directors started sitting with them. And the Kalmi school, you know, they develop an attitude and, you know, arrogance and all that, you know. Now, because I am attracting people who have an individual attitude. I hate that very slave-like culture which normally people have, you know. So my, again, coming back to this, when there are so many institutes, why start another institute if anyone asks that question? Precisely, I think the very title of the institute and also the four lines which is written in terms of professing its objectives itself will tell this is going to be unlike anything anyone has seen or experienced. And in terms of content generation or whatever it is, I think it will have methods which have never been heard of before. All those details will be given in about 20 days in a website which will be put up at a certain time, you know. And how the process will start and where it will be, and all those details will come at a later stage. But this press meet is primarily intended for people to know about the idea, and we are inviting people to apply on what kind of a criteria we require for people to apply, and what will be the selection process based on what needs to be. So we're trying to gather these applicants so that we zero in on who in a sensibility, who in a psychological pattern, whatever the Unschool is looking for, you know. We want to choose the students who we want to be a part of the Unschool based on a certain examination. And that is what the principal idea of this particular procedure is. So, any questions?
Many crafts, chala crafts in there.
Yeah.
Yes.
You see, I feel the main principal crafts in Unschool will be acting, directing, music, cinematography, editing, sound design. No? Any of the parts where you require a certain individualistic approach and a point of view, how you want to use them as storytelling elements. All that will be a part of the Bible school.
You are not offering writing courses?
It might happen in the later stage, not in the initial courses. Because I feel writing for me is a point of the thing. A filmmaker himself should write. I somehow feel writers should not be separate. Especially when they call a cinema is it's a visual medium. And the sound and picture has to go together. And if the person who's writing cannot imagine the picture, I'm fundamentally of this belief that they cannot be separated. The director should be the writer. If at all he has a writer, I don't think it should be a part of the instead a professional writer. Yeah.
When she first proposed
yeah.
Initially,
when she approached Shweta, she's not really from a film background or anything. I was first surprised, she's based in New York, she does lots of fashion shows and things like that, you know. And I was always against something like, to teach or things like that. And I never saw myself, because I used to sit in the back of the classroom and throw chalk pieces at my lecturers. That's my only experience in school. So for me to suddenly think of me as pretending to be a kind of a person who can make people learn, then she said, but that is not what I'm asking you to do. I'm just asking you to be yourself. And that is different. And the way you look at films, the way you explain films, or the way what it means to you is what the system of the unschooled should be. You know, which is why it will be different from anything else. So because I'm traditionally against all film institutes and the kind of teaching, I'm generally against education itself. You know?
If at all somebody wants to build it himself, they can really stand before the mirror. Why should he join unschool?
What? But that's the point. The unschool is going to teach how he can be himself, because most of the people don't seem to have that. See, if in 30 years I can't make you understand, as a journalist, what?
So
we haven't come to the fee structure yet, because there's a lot of things being planned, but the way it is completely done, and it will be, of course, different for different things in terms of, because like I said, none of them will be like what we used to like hearing a 6-month course, 1-year course, or there could be, probably there'll be something like, only for the duration of one project. And that project can happen very fast or very soon, depending upon the complexity of it, depending upon the person who's doing it, you know? So it won't operate like 6 months, 1 year, 2 weeks. Something can be only for 2 days, maybe. I'm just giving an example, you know? So that is the reason it's being called unschooled. Nothing will operate like a school or an institute. All those details are being worked on. It will be shared very soon. See, today's time, I think it's not like classroom. It's not like, of course, there'll be a lot of physical interaction in places. It will happen at least in 4 different places, and including the US. Yeah. Hyderabad, Bombay, and in New York, where she is from, and one other place we are going to visit. Regular and see the point is when I'm just releasing one, there are 10 questions or 7 questions to be answered to apply for this school, and directly based on their answers they will be shortlisted, and then there will be further examined. And then what? Yeah. Actually, now that you asked me, just as an example, I want to read a few questions what will be asked of all the applicants of the school. Name 10 best films that you really liked or were influenced by. This is to know the applicant's taste and sensibility. Name three of the worst films and write two or three lines on each of them and why you did not like them. This, the reasons will give a peek into the applicant's analytical intelligence. Cinema enduku nachaledu ani cheppadam kuda kale. Nachaledu baagundi baaledu chadagam ante ayyindi. Enduku nachaledu ani cheppinappudu you will understand the analysis power, you know. What is the last flop film you liked and why? ఇప్పుడు కొన్ని బ్యాడ్ సినిమా నచ్చినట్టు ఉంటారు కదా, ఆబ్వియస్లీ తనకేదో కనెక్ట్ అయింది మనకు తెలియదు, యూనో. ఉదాహరణకి ఆగ్ నచ్చిన కూడా నాకు ఒకటి కలిసాడు, ఒకటే కలిసి ఆగ్ ఆగ్ సినిమా నచ్చిన కూడా ఒకటి కలిసాడు. నా ఫోటో పెట్టుకుని నాకు ఫోటో పెట్టుకున్నాను ఇంట్లో, దేవుడి పట్టం తీసి అది పెట్టుకున్నాను. What is the last flop film you liked and why? This is to test the degree of intelligence in one's honesty. అంటే flops నాకు నచ్చింది ఎందుకు నచ్చింది అంటే ఆనెస్ట్గా చెప్పగలిగితే ఆబ్వియస్లీ దట్ ఈస్ అ క్రైటీరియా యు ఆర్ లుకింగ్ ఫర్ ఇన్ ది పర్సన్. వాట్ ఈస్ ద లాస్ట్ హిట్ ఫిల్మ్ యూ హేటెడ్ అండ్ వై? దిస్ ఈస్ టు టెస్ట్ హౌ స్ట్రాంగ్లీ వన్ ఈస్ ఒపీనియన్. కెన్ మెన్షన్ వన్ సీన్ ఎనీ ఫిల్మ్ విచ్ యూ థింక్ హ్యాస్ బీన్ వెరీ వెల్ డైరెక్టెడ్ అండ్ గివ్ యూర్ రీజన్స్. దిస్ ఈస్ టెస్ట్ హౌ మచ్ వన్ యాక్చువల్లీ అండర్స్టాండ్స్ డైరెక్టింగ్ ఇస్. చాలా బాగా డైరెక్ట్ చేశారండి, బట్ డైరెక్షన్ అంటే తెలుసా నేను ఫస్ట్ అప్పుడు ఏం చేశారు చెప్పు వస్తాను నాకు కదా, నాకు అర్థమయ్యేది చెప్పు, అది దర్శకం. అండ్ దెన్ ఇఫ్ యూ వర్ టు షూట్ సత్య నౌ ఆఫ్టర్ 20 ఇయర్స్, టుడేస్ అవైలబుల్ టెక్నాలజీ, ఏం కెమెరాస్ యూజ్ చేస్తావు అండ్ హౌ మెనీ డేస్? సో టుడే ఇన్ ద ఇంటర్నెట్ ఎవ్రీబడి నోస్ హౌ ఫిల్మ్స్ ఆర్ మేడ్, సీ ద మేకింగ్ అండ్ మెనీ పీపుల్ మేక్ ఇండిపెండెంట్ ఫిల్మ్స్. So even before coming to the institute, does he really have some understanding of how films are made? And practicality, anthropology, telusu, and adatanki, this question is designed for that. No? As a first attempt, what kind of film would you like to make and why? This is to understand a degree of one's ambition. So kottaga vachodu nenu bahubali chestanu avastada, you know, my ambition is to make bahubali ante chala chala ambitious, you know. అండ్ దెన్ వై అని అడిగినప్పుడు ఈ లైఫ్ ఆన్సర్ నేను రాజమౌళి కన్నా బెటర్ అని అనుకుంటాను అంటడా, అంటే అప్పుడు దాన్ని బట్టి ఆడు ఏ అంతస్తులో ఉన్నాడో తెలుస్తుంది. నేను అప్పుడు అదేంటి మీ అప్పుడు అప్పుడు వీ విల్ హ్యావ్ ఎన్ సెకండ్ ఈ క్వశ్చన్, అంటే నువ్వు వస్తే మరి పాపం రాజమౌళి కెరీర్ ఏమైపోతుంది, రాజమౌళి పట్టుకొట్టడానికి వస్తున్నావు నువ్వు ఇండస్ట్రీలోకి. సో ఇది లాట్ ఆఫ్ దీస్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ థింగ్స్ హ్యాపెనింగ్ టు ప్రొవోక్ అండ్ provocate a certain thing to get to know the real inside of him. And in this selection process, they'll be carefully taken out. No? So these are some of the questions, whatever I said, just to give you an example.
Is there a shortage of faculty?
Faculty? What?
That is
exactly the point. They won't be teachers.
Yeah.
This, see, there'll be, it will be a very, very interactive kind of a, process, you know. There'll be a very, very one-to-one level in terms of interaction and all that. It is not like you're putting a bunch of people there. No. It'll be almost like it doesn't sound right in a moral sense, but the nearest example I can give, which is like a terrorist outfit. It is like a radical terrorist, Thorabora Mountains, like under. No? I'm not saying about the place. The point is, it's like to imagine each individual as a separate filmmaker, you know? And there could be, the interaction will be almost on a one-to-one, maybe on a personal, physical level, or on giving him a project, you know? If you have a cell phone, if we ask him to just take whoever you want and give me 2-minute short film and only use the cell phone, somebody might be given something as complex as a visual effects film and ask him to do that. That is when I said the projects might differ in terms of what, you know? So everything will be taken independently as a project work by itself, like you're giving a contract out to that particular thing. And unschool will be providing the information which he might not have, you know, a guidance which he might not have in some issues, you know, Because any person who has passion can come and join the one school. No? And if you, and if you go back a little to schooling, for example, 4 years I was in engineering college. So I'm supposed to be civil engineer because I have a degree. And I don't know the mixture of cement concrete. But I have a degree. So a point in the day, when you go to an institute, they will commonly teach everybody something which people might not be interested in. Nee interest in unna je first. Aa interest batti nenu nerpisthan gaani nuvu em nechukovalanukunna nenu cheppanu. That for me is the fundamental difference between our school and any other school. So which is the reason I'm saying this system is geared for teaching on almost a one-to-one level. And the one-to-one in the classroom is there under the mantle. You should not imagine it as a classroom to start with. But that's the whole point. But those details will come to know later.
What is the motto, sir? What is the motto behind?
Motto is to, I want to make lot of terrorists and lead them into the film industry. Varma is just one of them. But I believe there are thousands of people who think like me. They're just not able because they don't want to go through that whole process of it and they're lost. So andarni ela vada rappicha chethu gun ichi meme rastam.
సార్ స్కూల్లో మీద ట్రైనింగ్ అవ్వకపోయినా బ్లాక్ బస్టర్ గిట్ కొట్టారు కదా, సో అంత అవసరం అంటారా స్కూల్ అనేది?
స్కూల్ 100% అవసరం అంటే ఇప్పుడు ఈవెన్ ఐ హ్యాడ్ ఎ స్కూల్, నా స్కూల్ ఏంటి, దట్స్ ఎ హోల్ థింగ్. ఐ సే ఐ వాజ్ నాట్ బోర్న్ విత్ సమ్ టాలెంట్ ఆర్ నాలెడ్జ్. ఐ లెర్న్ సంథింగ్ ఇన్ థియేటర్స్, ఐ లెర్న్ సంథింగ్ ఇన్ ద పీపుల్ ఐ మెట్ దట్ బికాస్ మై అంకుల్ వాజ్ ఎ ఫిల్మ్ బఫ్ అండ్ హీ హ్యాపన్ టు బి టేకింగ్ మీ లాట్ ఆఫ్ ఫిల్మ్స్. సో ఎవ్రీ పర్సన్ విల్ హ్యావ్ డిఫరెంట్ ఎక్స్పీరియన్సెస్. Every person will have his own sensibility, you know, his own IQ level. Prati okariki vere untadu kabatti, each of them has to be taken separately as a case study. Which is the reason I said, ippudu education lo, I feel as education enduku anedi first nerpichadu. Adi nerpichukunna chadu paatalu nenchuko, exam rasi ninni markulu raavalante, what is the nonsense? Why do you need to be educated? You should understand first, you know. So I will, that whole process, something because cinema is something my subject and I have 30 years of experience, good, bad, ugly and flop films and hit films, whatever I make. Out of all that experience, I systemized it, not to teach, but to make people unlearn, like I said.
So course I've been
30 years to learn experience, if I can manage to give it to the unschooled for a person on day one, he obviously can develop from that. He doesn't need to go through mental experience.
మీ
స్కూల్లో దట్ ఈస్ ప్రిసైజ్లీ ద పాయింట్. విత్ ఆఫర్ ఆబ్వియస్లీ విల్ కమ్ డైరెక్ట్లీ డిపెండింగ్ అపాన్ హిస్ టాలెంట్. ఆఫర్ డజన్ నాట్ బి ఇట్ ఇస్ నాట్ గివెన్ ఇన్ చారిటీ.
ప్లాన్
ఏమైనా ఉందా? ఆఫర్ ఇవ్వను, వాడుకుంటాను. ఆడి దగ్గర టాలెంట్ ఉందని తెలిస్తే ఆడికి తెలిసే లోపల నేను ప్రొడ్యూస్ చేసి డబ్బులు
చేసుకుంటాను.
పూర్ స్టూడెంట్ అని చెప్పారు కానీ మీ క్వాలిఫికేషన్ రాదు ఫస్ట్. అలాగే అడుక్కునే మెంటాలిటీ ఉంటే మా దగ్గరికి రావద్దు. పూర్
స్టూడెంట్
అఫోర్డబిలిటీ ఆబ్వియస్లీ విల్ డిపెండ్ అపాన్ దట్ స్పెసిఫిక్ థింగ్.
Do other schools, there are Ramanayadu school is there, there is Rangatha school, Prasad also start chesaru. Illandaru kuda ikkada middle unna time lo meeru start chestaru. Akkada kontha unaffordability undi, kontha ee level lo meeru how you are going to ee neeratha.
See, that directly will depend upon each project and that is more, I think, Shweta Reddy's prerogative, because I am just the creative head and not into administration and the financial part. Yeah.
Shweta ji, jaipan.
I'm going to unteach. Teach any word, I have a problem. So only we'll talk about my flops. I won't talk about my hits in this. In this. Hitler, I'm choosing already. I'll get it. నేను ఫ్లాప్ తీసాను, నేను కొంచెం టాలెంటెడ్ డైరెక్టర్ అయినా కూడా ఫ్లాప్ ఎందుకు తీసాను అని నేను మాట్లాడితే దే విల్ అండర్స్టాండ్ ఫ్రమ్ దాట్ మోర్ దెన్ మై హిట్ ఫిల్మ్స్. ఏం చేయకూడదో నేర్చుకో నేర్చుకుంటానికి బెటర్. ఏం చేయొచ్చు ఆల్రెడీ చూసావు సినిమాను, మళ్ళీ ఇంకేం చెప్పేది. నేను ఆ రోజు శివ సినిమా తీసినప్పుడు అని చెప్పాను అనుకోండి, అరే వద్దురా శివ 2006 ఎందుకు తీసాను, దాంట్లో నుంచి యూ విల్ లెర్న్ మోర్. ఎన్ సార్ యూ గాట్ యువర్ పాయింట్, థ్యాంక్స్.